Hey everyone, it's Mayor. Welcome back to the channel. And today, we have some more Pokemon Go news to go over. I wanted to let you guys know, I mentioned it in the previous video that I made, I'm going to be making some changes to the schedule. Instead of doing Pokemon news every Friday, I'm going to do them in shorts over the weekend. So if you're interested in Pokemon Masters, Pokemon Cafe, Scarlet and Violet, all those, they will be in shorts over the weekends. So like right now we have a new raid event in Scarlet and Violet. There's some upcoming stuff in Pokemon Masters and Cafe, so there will be a bunch of shorts coming out. So if you're interested in those, be sure to check out the channel over the weekend. We're going to make Friday another Pokemon Go News like day, so Monday is still TCG. Wednesday is Go News, and so is Friday. And then over the weekend, it's just random shorts. So just want to let you guys know before we get into today's article. We're going to be starting off with the January 2023 Community Day Classic, which is Larvitar. This thing is an absolute beast in the game. Tyranitar gets a Mega, which will be coming pretty soon, I'm guessing. It's one of the best Rock types, and it's a really good Dark type as well. So I highly recommend playing. This event will be starting very soon in some regions in the world, like New Zealand and Australia. So if you live there, be sure to be ready for the event. It's going to be a great one. But it will be taking place for everyone Saturday, January 21st from 2 to 5 p.m. local time. And it says, Trainers Community Day Classic returns in January. This event will feature the Rock Skin Pokemon Larvitar. We'll have an increased chance of being shiny, which will be 1 in 25, so pretty good odds to get shiny Larvitar. The featured attack for Tyranitar is Smackdown, which is a quick move. In Trainer Battles, it does 12 power, and in Gyms and Raids, it's 16. They also have the $1 ticket available, which has been in the shop for about a week now. So you'll get some extra items like Lucky Eggs, and you'll earn encounters with Larvitar and a Tyranitar at the very end. Pretty good deal for a dollar if you want to go for that, get some free items, it's pretty cool. The event bonuses are really big. We have triple XP, 3-hour lures and incense, and 5 snapshots, which will lead to Larvitar encounters, which is pretty cool. I mean, it's really big, because right now it's the Lunar New Year event, and if you pick the Stardust route, you'll have triple XP for catching Pokemon, and you'll have double Stardust during the community day. Plus, after the event ends, if you want to trade some Larvitars, you'll have an increased chance of getting lucky, which is really good, really cheap for powering up Tyranitar, which I highly recommend getting it to level 40, possibly even a level 50 if you're over level 31 and get the XL candies. So that's pretty much it for Larvitar Day. It's going to be pretty cool. There is also a little bit more news that I did not get to cover. And they posted it right after my last video dropped on Wednesday, which is kind of why I'm doing the Friday thing now. We have Primal Reversion has been discovered in Pokemon Go. So this was already told for the Hoenn Tour. We're getting the Primals, which is really cool. But it's working like Megas, which we kind of expected, because you can't really get the red and blue orb like the main games. You can't just have that in your item decks. So basically how it's going to work is, I'll read it here. You can earn Primal Energy by defeating Primal Kyogre or Primal Groudon in a raid battle, or by completing specific research tasks. So you get Primal Energy from like defeating them like a normal Mega Raid, and some quests as well, like they have power up 10 times and that can give like random Mega Energy. It's going to be like that. And after undergoing Primal Reversion, Primal Kyogre and Primal Groudon will stay in their Primal form for 8 hours, after which they will return to their standard form. The more times your Pokemon undergoes Primal Reversion, the less Primal Energy will be used, which is basically how it works for all Megas in the game. The new bonuses, this is where it's really going to be a little bit different. You'll receive bonuses when your Kyogre or Groudon reverts to the Primal form. When Primal Kyogre is in your party, Water, Electric, and Bug-type attacks will benefit from attack bonuses in raids, and when it is your buddy, catching Water, Electric, and Bug-type Pokemon will give you more XP and candy. So, basically, how it works in the main games is their abilities would like make the weather really harsh, so like Groudon's would be like harsh sunlight, and Kyogre's would be harsh rain. So that's kind of what they're going for here. It boosts the spawns, well, not the spawns, like the candy and XP of the Pokemon that spawn in those weathers, which makes sense, because Kyogre's rain, so it gets water, electric, and bug. And Groudon, if it's in your party, fire, grass, and ground-type attacks will benefit from the attack bonus. And if it's your buddy, catching fire, grass, and ground-type will give you more XP and candy, which is how it is for sunny weather. It's a pretty interesting little detail they threw in, and I really like that. It's going to be really cool if you get, like, a good community day and you can start leveling up your Kyogre and Groudon's Primal level. That'll be really good. New Pokédex category, it's only for these two, which is pretty cool. The Pokédex category for Mega Pokemon will be updated to include Pokemon that have undergone Primal Reversion, so it's just them two. Because Mega Rayquaza is just a regular Mega, so we're going to see how that goes. You'll be able to encounter Primal Groudon and Kyogre in raids during specific periods, beginning with the Hoenn Tour Las Vegas. So if you got a ticket, congrats, they're all sold out now. So if you're going to that, good luck with the raids and have an awesome time. Super jealous. Trainers will also have opportunities during both the Hoenn Tour Las Vegas and the global event to complete Primal Surge field research, which may lead to increased opportunities of encountering Primal Kyogre or Primal Groudon in raids. This is also really big. They're getting their special moves. So Kyogre's special moves, Origin Pulse, and Groudon has Precipice Blade. So Origin Pulse has 130 power in both trainer battles and gyms and raids. Same with Precipice Blade, so 130 each. And I wanted to mention this before I forgot. Your previous Primal Groudon, well, your Groudon and Kyogre you've caught previously in past raid events, they can Primal Evolve. So, like, I have a level 40 maxed out 98% shiny Groudon. I want to Primal Evolve that one. Obviously, it's going to get really high CP. You can do that. It just won't have these special moves, but you can probably Elite TM them at some point, which I highly recommend. Because if you're really into, like, the raid scene, these moves are going to be really good for both of them. For PvP, it's kind of like a toss-up for Kyogre. It has its benefits, and I'm not too sure about Groudon. I haven't looked into it too much, so sorry about that. But I highly recommend doing these raids during the event, because these moves will be really good, get some good trade bait, and possibly even some shinies. And that's really about it for the news today. So thank you guys for checking it out. Have an awesome time with Larvitar Community Day. Let me know in the comments below how many shinies you get, how many good Tyranitars you got. And I will see you guys back here again on Monday with the next Pokemon TCG opening.